Are you ready for some Jersey? Well, we've got Jersey. The zipper was made here. The light bulb was made here. The color television calls the Garden State home. Everybody wants to know about New Jersey. Sandy beaches, beautiful cities. We even have the Jersey Turnpike. Inventors, music, the movies. You need an exit? We got them too. You want Jersey? This is Jersey.
Say what? They dope, but we dope, but we bringing it back, yeah. We bringing it old school back, 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 yeah, yeah.
Welcome to this edition of This Is Jersey. Right now, you're hearing the ladies of BLUSHHH Music, a new girl group managed by Mathew Knowles of the Destiny's Child fame. Rappers Sunny, Bunny Ray, and vocalist Tally are currently traveling the U.S. and spreading the word about this new hot trio who promises to bring old school back. We caught up with Knowles to ask him about his newest talent and what we can expect from them. So tell us about BLUSHHH Music.
Well, you know, Gary, I saw this band about 2.5 years ago. I have a complex there in Houston at Music World. I was actually coming, I teach at Texas Southern University, and so after one of my night classes, I thought I'd stop by. There was a showcase going on. And sure enough, here's these three girls, actually two of them singing, one of them rapping, but they were trying to do Destiny's Child. And we've already done that, and that's hard or impossible to duplicate. So I gave them some feedback, and I said, ladies, I asked the second girl, I said, can you rap at all? And she says, as a matter of fact, I can. I can rap better than I can sing. I said, well, why didn't y'all do that? Why didn't you have two rappers and a singer? They were like, well, we didn't think that's what people wanted, you know, or what you wanted. I said, no, that's exactly what I want, something different. And so I asked them and challenged them to work on a song with two rappers and come back the following week. And they did, and they did okay. And then I challenged them to work on it, and they came back the next week, and they did better. And that's when I decided that I would sign them, and I signed them on the spot. And that's how it happened. And I told them that it would take 2 years of artist development. And by artist development, I mean everything from vocal lessons, even with the rappers. Folks think, well, how can a rapper take vocal lessons? Well, you have to learn breathing techniques. Everything from that to, you know, it takes a while to develop an image. That doesn't just happen overnight. Also, we did team building exercises. Actually, went to a therapist so that they can understand, you know, some of the psychological, personal things and how your personal life interfaces with your professional life. And then we start making the album, and that was a process, a concept. And then it's choreography and putting together the show, and then rehearsal. And so that's the artist development process that they've been.
In your artist development, you ask the girls to lose weight as well. What's that all about?
Well, we're in a pretty person's business. I mean, I don't make the rules, but if you're going to compete in pop and R&B, there's a certain image that has to be. So they understood that. And that wasn't me asking them. That was me demanding it. That's the only way I would do it, because I know it would fail. So they put in the work. Their fitness coach is now the road manager. I had to train an artist develop the road manager because he knew nothing about the industry, but he was committed to the project. And I was committed to teaching him how to become a good road manager.
Now, who writes most of the music?
The girls write all of their lyrics, the rappers, and the vocalists. They are very, very creative artists. And then, of course, they don't do the track part of it, but when it comes to their lyrics and their rap, they are 100% it's them. And occasionally I go in and I add something here and I add something there, almost on every song.
Now let's talk about the last 2 years, where they've performed and where they're at now.
Well, in the last 2 years, you know, knowing me, and I learned to do this quicker, faster, sooner. Unfortunately, I had to replace a member. And so that happened about a year and a half ago. And fortunately, as always, we find someone who can even bring more value to the group. And the group got better, and the imaging got better. And so now, we really, as of 2 months ago, we've gone to radio, we shot a video, and we're here in New York because Radio One, which is our largest African-American radio network, with over 64 radio stations. All of their program directors was here last night for a showcase, and the ladies absolutely killed it. As a matter of fact, I've spoken today to two major record labels to joint venture possibly with Music World. It's probably 35% music, 65% business. That's the first thing they don't know. The second thing is that the margin of success of this is extremely low. No different than basketball, no different than football, or any sports. You have millions of people around the world that want to do this. And only less than 5% ever get an opportunity to, and 99% of that 5% fail. So it's a 1% success rate. And so you have to start young. You can't at 25, 26 decide this is what you want to do. You're competing against people who started at 8. Just like basketball players who started at 8. You can't think at 23 you're going to compete with Michael Jordan who started at 8. Or Beyonce Knowles who started at 8. Or Justin Timberlake who started at 8. Or I can go on and on and on of artists we know that we say their name. They started at 8 and 9 doing this.
How has the radio industry changed since you started with Beyonce?
Not only has the radio industry changed, every aspect of the industry has changed. We could talk about CDs. We could talk about videos. So every aspect has changed. But when we talk specifically about radio, you know, today's youth, we're talking about that 13, 14, 15-year-old, they're not listening to FM radio. For the most part, they're streaming. For the most part, they're listening to digital radio. So that's the biggest change, is that digital radio streaming has really become a way that folks are listening and taking in, experiencing music. Now, radio, FM radio has not gone away, and it still plays an important part. I would say somewhere in the 30, if I had a pie, it would be somewhere like 35% of importance, where before it might have been 60 or 70% importance. It's still important, but certainly not to where it was before. And the younger and younger it gets, the less and less we'll start seeing FM, unless they change and work really on their digital aspect of the business.
The ladies you have are just great. Tell me the qualities that make each one of them work with the group.
Well, I mean, when you have a group, the dynamics are different. It's a team. It's no I, it's we. Every team member has to know their position. And no, again, no different than sports. You have to know your position, but more importantly, you have to buy into that position. And so that's the one thing that's working with a group that's different, and working with a girl group is even more of a challenge. And I've had experience working with girl groups and the dynamics of females, because you have an emotional aspect, an element sometimes that you have to really deal with and deal with immediately. And then there's that number one thing that breaks up girl groups. You know what that is?
Money?
Men. And so you have to look at those dynamics and constantly be on top of all of it.
What a wonderful story, and got a lot of great things going on. We have to take a break now. We come back, I want to talk about Destiny's Child and how it all began, and we'll do that when we come back. And thank you for watching. We'll be back right after this.
And I'ma pull up and act like this. You about to witness some kind of greatness. Appreciate your hating. My girls in the back with you, just finessing, no plexing, and that's true.
That's true.
I think we're doing better than you. You might have done it first, but it's about who did it the best. I let you get it. Check that off your list. You're over there thinking about a word about this. Won't live my life wasting time. You need a moment of clarity. This is reality. You feeling me? Wave your hands like you just don't care. Flip your weave if that ain't your real hair. Cause we in the drop top of the parking lot. Jamming every hip hop and the ear don't stop.
It's all good, baby. So it all started with Star Search, or did it start even before then with Destiny's Child?
Well, it actually did. I mean, Destiny's Child went through an evolution of names. Everything from Girls' Time, which is what Star Search, the name of the group, was. And from there, it became the Dolls, when they were signed with a production company. Babyface and L.A. Reid's writing partner, Daryl Simmons. And then from there, it went from Something Fresh was the name.
Okay.
So then it became Destiny. We found out that there was a gospel group in Mississippi with the name Destiny. So
that's, right.
That's when I had to add either something in front of Destiny or after Destiny, and I chose to make it Destiny's Child. At that time, I was a proud father. I'm in corporate America, and I'm doing what dads do, support their kids, support their passion, not mine. So my job was to carry the wardrobe. So I had two racks of wardrobe. They thought they were gonna win four consecutive times, which was the max you could win. We got one hotel room just for the wardrobe. That was my job. And I had warned the then managers, who were very new at this, that I didn't think it was a good idea for them to rap on Star Search on a song, because no one had ever done that before. And when you got older 50-year-old white men and you're the first to rap on Star Search, might not be a good idea. And it wasn't a good idea. They had much better material. And sure enough, they lost, crying their eyes out. I walk up to Ed McMahon and I said, "Mr. McMahon, I'm just a dad. I'm seeing these kids cry their heart out. What do I do?" And he's deep voice, "Mr. Knowles, I don't understand it myself. Everybody that consistently win on this show, they never professionally go on in their career. But it's those that lose, change their organization, refocus, rededicate. Those are the ones that have a chance of making it." And that's what we did. I partnered with one of the managers. We unfortunately had to let go of the dancers. We changed one of the members, and then that's what happened. That's exactly what happened.
Then Beyonce goes and has her career beyond Destiny's Child. What was that like? And were you involved with her career after that?
Oh, absolutely. I was involved 20 years in Beyonce's career. But it wasn't overnight. This was strategy. Beyonce didn't just one day start a Beyonce career. The strategy was, what happened is that we made three Destiny's Child albums. Then on the fourth, we did solo albums of each and every one, Kelly and Michelle. Kelly won a Grammy on her first solo single, and an album went platinum. Michelle was the number one gospel artist on her first gospel album. And so Beyonce had success with her pop and R&B. So each one of the ladies had individual success to build the brand and to build the audience. It was a strategy. And then we did another Destiny's Child, then another solo, then another Destiny's Child, and then a third solo.
So what's the future of Destiny's Child and Beyonce's involvement with the group?
Well, I'm hopeful. I know that the ladies are getting older. Their window is getting smaller. And I'm hopeful that they understand that the window is getting smaller. And if they're going to do this, they need to do it now, because it would be phenomenal. I don't know how you would pick what songs to perform, because you would have to perform all of their number ones. And I guess it would be a 4-hour concert of just them, or a part one night and part two the second night. That would probably be the better idea. But I hope they see that opportunity.
What's the future for, obviously with BLUSHHH Music, the future of music, but girl music throughout the next generation? What do you think we're gonna see more of? More of the 60s style or more of the hip hop?
Well, I think you'll see a combination of both. As music is merging, you know, there's not that big gap between one and the other as it used to be. So I think just like ties got fatter and then they got smaller, just like skinny legs were bell bottoms and then they go back to skinny legs, you're gonna see a resurgence in the next year of girl groups. And there'll only be one or two, maybe three, but I'm very, very hopeful and confident that BLUSHHH Music will be one of those.
Hence the reason you're the businessman.
I guess so.
Now tell our viewers before we have to go how they can learn more about BLUSHHH Music, their website.
Well,
Facebook.
You certainly could go to BLUSHHH Music, BLUSHHH music.com. You can go to all of their social media sites. Their single is available on iTunes, also their video. And you'll be hearing a lot of these girls. They're beginning to get airplay at radio. There's a buzz, as we call in the industry. And I'm happy for them because, just like Destiny's Child, they're good people. And I always root for people that are really good people. They deserve to win.
Very good. And you're a good person. Thank you
so much.
God bless. Thank you. And thank you for watching. We'll see you again next time.